xenon forms 6 hours later and interferes with the fine equilibrium of the nuclear reaction. The engineer in charge, Anatoly Dyatlov, was under pressure to do the test. He made the fateful decision to extract almost every control rod to bring the reactor back up to enough power for the test. This was like in a car applying more than full throttle to counter a jammed handbrake. 1 hour after the reactor stalled, the controllers had raised the power back up to 6%. The test was performed at 1:23 a.m. and lasted 40 seconds. The control staff had agreed beforehand, upon completion of the test, the AZ-5 button was to be pushed to complete the shutdown. The control staff reported all was calm at this time. You may be familiar with the flip cover and rotating switch, but this was the retrofit after the disaster. The button Leonid Toptanov famously pushed was most likely this one. The control rods were in this configuration when the AZ-5 was pushed. It is frightening that there was just one rod fully inserted. At no time should the core have had less to power back up to 6%. The test was performed at 1:23 a.m. and lasted 40 seconds. The control staff had agreed beforehand, upon completion of the test, the AZ-5 button was to be pushed. The reactor had been pushed too far. The AZ-5